Hello, everyone. My name is Eleanor. Are we good? This is different using a mic. Usually I project. So I've got this all wrong here. So I accepted a phone call from Abby. I was meant to go to another staff member, and she said, just talk for 2 minutes. And I was like, sure. Now it's 6 minutes plus, and it's a bunch of slides, but I'm here. I'm going to do my best. I think I've also cheated, because the slides don't actually go with what I'm saying, so just go with it. But they are the faces of unlikely producers. So that's what I want to talk about. And I also went with a script, which she also told me don't do that. So I believe, and I'm going to talk about self-reliant groups, and it's in these SRGs, as we call them, that I think unlikely producers are born. And I think the first steps of really ensuring that we have a strong making economy, especially here in Scotland, is finding those unlikely producers. And so these are their faces. But before I delve into these self-reliant groups, I want to start with us. Because so often, I think, when looking at an issue or problem, we need to start by looking at what's right in front of us, what's in us. And I would venture to say, and it might be rather bold, but I think that ultimately we limit the possibilities of a making economy because of the ways in which we view people, and especially those people in our deprived communities. We often label them as lazy, as scroungers, as people that don't have anything to contribute, but rather, what if we saw them as people who have so much to contribute to this making economy? In the third sector especially, we often see people as clients, as consumers, as someone in need of a service. So the challenge I want to pose to us today is, what if we shifted that perspective? What if instead of seeing people as consumers or clients of a service, instead we saw them as producers within this wider making economy? For me, SRGs are the starting point for this. Taking inspiration from India, as Abby said, where there are over 8 million SRGs, we now have 45 SRGs in Scotland. They all look different, but they kind of hold to these four or five principles. They're 5 or 10 members, they meet regularly, they save small amounts of money together, they share their skills, and they just get started. They aren't dependent on outside funding, and they dare to dream big. And it's within these spaces that people who would never see themselves as producers and makers begin to see that they too have potential to enter in a realm that's traditionally reserved for creatives. Supporting people to understand their making potential is, I think, where it all begins. So I'll tell you briefly the story of Christine, and obviously that's not Christine. But 3 years back or 2 years back, whenever the Commonwealth Games were going on here, we had a marketplace stall for all of the SRG members, and one of them came up to me and said, hey, Eleanor, I think you need to go talk to Christine. I think she's high, or I think she's drunk. I thought, great, throw me under the bus, make me go have that conversation. But I went to her and I said, hey, Christine, is everything okay? And Christine looked at me with tears in her eyes and a big smile on her face, and she said, Eleanor, someone bought something that I made. Someone paid money for something that I created. And it was in that moment that I saw the power of production. Someone had seen her as a producer with something beautiful and meaning to offer, and that in turn gave her a newfound sense of self-worth. It was so simple and yet so poignant. So the question then becomes, what within SRGs makes productivity possible so that we can have more Christines across the UK? And I quickly want to propose three things. It's this environment. It's an SRG environment that is built on aspirations rather than needs. Karen from one of our alpacas SRGs described it as a space where you have full permission to believe you can. The only starting point for people joining an SRG is an aspiration to do more. And that aspiration looks different for everyone. For one group, it was starting a laundry. They started by running a lunch club, saving £2 a week, saving up that money, and eventually taking out a small loan and providing the community's first laundry facilities, so they no longer had to travel into the city center. For Keep It Sweet SRG in Dundee, it meant taking out a small loan and getting a candy cart so they could run this out across events. An environment that says, experiment, create, and dream big. The second key thing is this SRG mindset. As you can pick up from their name, SRGs are self-reliant and not dependent on funding. Because they're not dependent on funding, production tends to be ingrained from the onset. To afford teas or coffees, to afford sewing machines for making products, or capital for their next big idea, they have to start with making. Mary Hill is a great example of that around the corner. Every week, for 1 week, they got a donated sewing machine. A woman who knew how to sew taught each member how to sew. They brought in scrap fabrics and they began making and selling that. And today they own over 12 sewing machines. A mindset that says, just get started somewhere. And so they started with production. And lastly, this SRG motivation to be role models. Most of the SRG members are women, and they want to produce and create so that their children can see another way of working. They want their children to see them actively working towards something, and it is in that creating that they are actually rewriting stories for their families. It's a motivation to produce for more than just themselves. So it's in these three things. It's within this environment that says you can just do it. It's a mindset that says just get started, and it's a motivation to have that trickle-down effect on families that give life to this idea of production. But before I close, and I think I'm on track, I want to circle back to Christine. By harnessing her own sense of productivity, Christine ended up writing a different ending to her story. After she sold that heart, she kept on producing. And through making, she gained the confidence to go to a job interview, and today she's employed, creating a whole new life for herself that simply started by making. So that's the self-reliant groups. We actually, this is my selfless plug because I have 20 extra seconds here. We're looking for any designers that want to be involved in helping kind of take directions for some of the products that we're creating. We have over 45 of these self-reliant groups across Scotland, and all of you are welcome to come see them. They are doing a variety of different things, so you're welcome anytime. Thank you.